So the new color of the car is going to be... Hey guys, hope you're doing well. Today we officially begin fixing the damage on the Fusion, and the first order of business is to get a new bumper. So, checked out Rockwall Ford, they had one, so I ordered it, and it is now available for pickup. So we are currently in my mom's Escalade. Thanks mom, because it's one of the few vehicles that should fit it. I don't know if it's gonna be just out and about or in a box or whatnot, but we got the back seats down, we got the middle seats down, so it should fit. But we do have a long day ahead of us and a lot of work, so we are here at Sonic to get ourselves a nice recharger, get everything going. So I got the bumper, and it's not in a box or anything, it's wrapped up in this, which makes it a lot easier to fit in there. And yeah, it's just a casual little Ford bumper. With the bumper now here, we can officially start this parts haul for the Fusion. I wanna give a big shout out to Rockwall Ford for getting this order in, even with their systems down. But rather than just fixing what needs to be fixed, I figure let's go ahead and lean into the third iteration of this car, V3. The first iteration was the monochromatic black and white. The second one, the gray, purple, black interior, silver wheels. Now for this third one, we do have some new vinyl. We're gonna go for a complete color change on the car, but we'll get into this a little bit later because obviously we wanna save the best for last. And the best thing about a brand new bumper is there are no holes here in the center section where the dealer decides that they wanna just drill in some random holes for the license plate. But the second thing is we are gonna be sending this to the body shop to get this little area smoothed over. This is the indentation for the Ford emblem. I think it'll look a lot better just completely smooth, so that's gonna be what we're gonna go for. Good? We also have a new set of headlights for the car. These are the headlights with the built-in Demonize. I absolutely love these. I ran these on my car a couple months ago for the giveaway. Shout out to Brady for winning. And then a company reached out to me, TTABC, one of the sellers for these headlights. And so we partnered up. And so I figure with all these new pieces, new look for the car, maybe it's time for a set of new headlights as well. And the two most notable aspects of these headlights by far are the startup animations and the built-in Demonize. I think this is a very ideal scenario because out of the box, you have some really cool and unique functionality without having any of the, you know, aspects of doing a retrofit. Because in doing a retrofit, you do have to cut open the headlights, cut up a good bit of what's in there just to, you know, get the new pieces to fit and mess with the wiring. And there's a decent amount of room for error, which is unfortunately, I think, what happened with my Mustang style headlights, because the RGB functionality is there and the normal functionality is there as well. But it seems like there was some stuff that was messed with that I don't know if it wasn't supposed to be messed with or what, but I don't know if I'm gonna hold on to these. I might sell them, maybe. Just DM me on Instagram if anything. But it is very fitting. New look for the car, all these new pieces, new headlights as well. You can buy a set from their website or from their Amazon store. I'm gonna link them both in the description box down below. From their website specifically, I do have a discount code DITO8 to save yourself 8% off your order. I also had this package come in. Now this is something I've been waiting on for a minute, but it's a little too special to just throw along with everything else. So it's gonna get its own dedicated video. But if you guys know what it is, go ahead and comment down below. You'll get a shout out in that video. In here, we have the last of the new under panels for the car. So we started off with the under tray that had the removable sections to do oil changes a lot easier, as well as some jacking rails from Steeda that we installed in the car. The thing is, those are just super practical for the car, so went ahead and installed those first. But here we have the last of the panels to basically replace the whole front end section of the vehicle. A new fender well. We got one for both sides because they were a really good deal, actually. Here is the other one. I don't know which side is the front or the back, but they're basically just mirrors of the same piece. And lastly, we have the piece that goes in the front with the bumper. So my old one actually has a little bit of overspray on it, so it's just a nice little cleanup piece, nothing crazy. But being that we have new bumper, new front shield, whatever you want to call it, new fender liners, new piece under there. Basically, the entire front end of the vehicle is gonna have all new under panels, which is something I've been needing to take care of on here for a minute. We've also got a new set of brake pads because just need a new set of brake pads. And a piece I was looking for a while that I didn't know existed until somewhat recently, a center console lid with red stitching from the factory. So whenever I got my seats reupholstered in blue, I also had the center console lid reupholstered just so everything was nice and uniform. When I sold the seats, sold the center console lid as well, so I had been basically without one for a minute. When I swapped to the center stage interior package with black and red seats, I was looking for a center console lid that would match, just a black one, up until I found out that the black cloth seats with red stitching had a black leather center console lid with red stitching, so it should fit very, very well. For whatever reason, couldn't find too many of these, but I found this one in really good condition, just needs to be a little cleaned up, but should be a great addition to the car. We also have our new fog light bezels. Now the bezel itself mounts on the inside of the bumper, just kind of clicking in like that. The spears actually mount on the outside, basically just like sandwiching the bumper. It's gonna be pretty cool. I can't wait to get these on as well. Now we can go ahead and unveil the new color of the car. So the new color of the car is going to be candy metallic silver gray blue. So this color is pretty similar to the color that is on the car now. This is the candy metallic gray purple. This is the candy metallic silver gray blue. But one of the main things that, I don't know if the camera's picking it up too well, but whereas this car has a gray base just in the color, this has more of a purple base. Now here at this angle, you can get a little bit more of the difference between the two colors. This is like the base when there's very low light. Gray base, purple base. But the other thing, if you get some light on these, as you can see, this highlight is very pinkish purple. On this one, it is blue. Now I did want to go for a similar color, which is why I chose this. And I do think it's gonna look a lot more different whenever it's actually on the car and you get a lot more of the angles, because as of right now, you're not getting too much of a difference. I guess a kind of casual way to simplify it, whereas this shifts from gray to purple, this is already that purple, and then it also adds a shift to blue. But that's gonna do it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to stay tuned because next week we're gonna be removing this wrap entirely, and I'll give you guys an honest review of how the vinyl has held up after 2 years. And then we'll be moving on to this wrap.